So, I just saw this equation on the math stack exchange, and my first thought is, I know how to solve it by using triangles, because I've done a similar question before. But anyways, I'm going to give you guys a link in the description to the page where you can read about how other people solve it. Usually it's about a very clever algebraic trick. But right here, you definitely do not want to square both sides, otherwise the result is going to be pretty crazy. But go ahead and try the following. If we have a sum of two square root parts, and notice that they are both subtraction inside, and this and that are the same, then we can try to do this. Starting from this part first, I'm going to put that onto a right triangle. Like this. And because we have this goes first, I'm going to put this on the hypotenuse. But I'm going to use the Pythagorean theorem later. And there's no square. So I'm actually going to label this side as square root of x. And then I'm going to put this right here, and I'm just going to do the same thing. I will take the square root of it, which is square root of 1 is 1, square root of x on the bottom like this. All right? Now, ladies and gentlemen, when we have this right triangle, we can figure out this side. We first open the square root, and all we have to do is the hypotenuse squared, square square root cancel, so we just have x, minus this side squared, and square root square cancel, so we just have 1 over x, just like that. Now, for the other one, we are going to do the same thing. But they have this part in common, so I'm just going to draw the triangle where they share this side, and I just need to have a 1, let's say it goes like this, right here. So, of course, this is a right triangle, and now this is 1. Cool. Now, let's do the same thing. This side here is just going to be the square root of the hypotenuse square, which is just 1, minus this thing square, which is 1 over x. That's that. Now, what the question wants to do is, we want to have this plus that equals x. So we want to have the red part plus the blue part being equal to x. So this is our triangle that we are looking for to satisfy. Okay, so how can we continue? Well, let's have a look. Notice this whole thing right here is the base of the big triangle. We can just look at that as x. This is the height. It's 1 over square root of x. So know that the area of the triangle is just going to be 1 half times the base times the height. Good. But what if we look at this side and that side? I don't know if this is the 90 degree yet. However, if we can say that this is the base and this is the height, then for sure that has to be 90 degrees. Yeah? So we would like to compute, suppose this is the base, and then let's just go ahead and do 1 half times base times that height, supposedly. If this is true, then we can say that this is base, that would be the height, and that would be the right angle. Well, in fact, it is true because x over square root of x is just square root of x on the top, and then we have that over 2. You can do x to the first power, and then this is x to the 1 half power. 1 minus 1 half is x to the 1 half power, so just like that. We'll rationalize the denominator, up to you. This is indeed equal to, that is just square root of x over 2. So they match. Base times height, base times height. So we can say that has to be a 90 degree angle as well. Now what though? Well, here, when we have this, this, and that, do not look at this part anymore, because x is so much cuter compared to that, right? We can use the Pythagorean theorem on the big triangle. And of course, let's just go ahead and square this term. So square root of x, square that, and then we add this thing squared, and that has to be equal to this square. And many of you guys, I believe, have noticed that this is going to give us the golden ratio, right? This is the golden quadratic equation. And let's just solve it real quick. I will keep this on the right-hand side, that's x squared, but I'm going to put it on the left. This is just x, put it to the other side, so that's x. That's 1, go to the other side, that's minus 1, and that's equal to 0. And let's just use the quadratic formula. X is equal to negative b, which is negative 1, plus or minus square root of b squared, which is negative 1 squared, minus 4ac, a is 1, c is negative 1, over 2 times a. Work this out real quick. X is equal to 1 plus or minus square root, that's 1, and this right here is plus 4, so we have 5 all over 2. Okay, so that's it. Well, no, not yet. Pay attention to what we have originally. We have a square root plus another 1, so the right hand side cannot be negative. If you look at the x right here, we have the 1 minus square root of 5. Square root of 5 is bigger than 1, so 1 minus square root of 5 will give us negative result. We don't want the left hand side to be negative, right? Because that's x. So we will have to get rid of the negative here. There, the only answer is indeed the golden ratio, which is very cool for this equation. X is equal to 1 plus square root of 5 over 2. But if you want to be even cooler than this, just write it as phi, right? That's a symbol for the golden ratio, which is approximately 1.618. Yeah, that's it.